on. I'm Wendell Jones, and welcome to this edition of our program, The Platform. And on our program today, we are going to put some emphasis on breast cancer. And over the many years, we've done a number of programs here on this particular issue. And we are grateful to Nygard Inc. For what they have been doing, not only in the Bahamas, but around the world, in bringing attention to the need to fight this dreaded disease, breast cancer among women. Bianca Nygard, it's good to see you.
Thank you. It's nice to be here again.
Yes, you come in a very nice dress here today. I like the colors of this dress. Later in the program, we're going to be talking about what Peter Nygard has been doing in breast cancer research and treatment, not only in the Bahamas, but in Canada and other places.
Yes.
But as of now, our guest is Rashad Dean, who is the CEO of Soctacular.
Yes, correct.
Bahamian Design Socks.
Yes, sir.
How are you doing?
All is well, sir.
Good to see
it's
you.
It's a pleasure being here.
Good. What brought this about, this company, Soctacular?
Actually, Soctacular, it was birthed stateside when I was on vacation. And actually, I just sat beside the pool area, and I had a few friends that I was basically chilling with, and we was discussing ways to make extra source of income. And then he was like, you know what, back in the Bahamas, you guys don't have any like that much of a wacky type socks type of venture. And I was like, you know what, you're right, you know. Mm. And then me being so artistic, because I'm an artist, I said, well, is it possible that I should like create some particular design? Or how would it look like? And then I went back in my room, and I took one of the actual notepads on the desk and the pen. I said, you know, and I sat there for like about an hour or so, and I just did some random sketch, and I said, you know what, this could actually work. So I just went forward from there and then started creating socks.
So you started designing socks.
Yes, sir.
And I see you have a lot of pink socks.
Yes, it's breast cancer month.
So for breast cancer month.
Yes, sir.
So how has it been going?
So far it's been up and down hill with the socks itself, but if we reach out to persons in various areas that who had persons who passed away from cancer, not just breast cancer, but cancer itself. So like I said, the meaning behind the cancer socks is pretty much personal to me, because I had a grandfather who passed from lung cancer. Mm. And I have a father, he's a survivor from colon cancer. Mm. So it pretty much critiqued in all that I put behind the work itself and the design itself with the socks. So it pretty much means a lot to me.
Bianca, you know, you do a fantastic job. I say this every week in finding these guests, you know.
Thank you so much. You know, Rashad is a friend of mine, and yes. I really love when Bahamians are coming up with these great ideas to be their own entrepreneur and make their own business. So I'd like to promote it. Mm. But as far as the cancer socks, you know, men can get breast cancer also.
Yes.
Yes. So it's important for everybody to do their checks and early detection.
Yeah.
But your socks are for men and women, right?
Yeah, so you're unisex.
Good. You have them closed up, man. Yes. Let's see these socks that you have designed. Pink socks.
Yeah, these are the actual female version.
Okay.
So as you can see, we have some men that loves pink.
Mm-hmm. So these are designed by yourself.
Yes, sir.
And this is the pink, and this is the pin that they normally use, right?
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm.
Mm.
It is very fashionable for men to be wearing just what their business suit or just regular jeans and a top, like what you're wearing, and then have these funky socks on, you know, that you could just see. That's a real big fashion statement, you know, Mr. Jones.
These funky socks you got.
Okay. Yes, sir.
How do you think I'd look in a pink socks?
Well, based on your opinion, well, actually, just it stands out itself.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All of my designs stand out itself. So we just, like I said, each design that I created, it has a meaning to it.
Yeah. Given the number of people who have been afflicted with this disease, you should have a ready market for
yes,
this.
Sir. Yes, sir. Like I said, it's a small business, and like I said, we just reaching out to a person. So it wasn't really that consistent, But now that, hey, I have all of my products in here on time and all that stuff, so basically we have persons who are actually interested, so I'm actually in conjunction with the Cancer Society now.
Okay.
So then we have other persons, international and home abroad, so yeah.
Where are they actually made?
I send them abroad.
Oh, they made abroad?
Yeah, they'll be designed here and they send them to be imported.
And you should have a market outside the country as well.
Yes, sir.
Are you marketing it outside
yes,
the Bahamas?
Sir. Yes, sir.
In places like where?
In Texas, California. I have a few friends in Cuba just recently, and Florida.
Yes. Now, you are doing socks, making these socks in addition to promoting cancer awareness. Mm-hmm. I see from that billboard you have there
yes.
that you have some other colors.
Yes, sir. I have about like 9 designs.
Okay.
The first design, as you can see on the actual banner in the blue, is my first design, which is the blue marlin socks, where you can see it has a display of hibiscus and a mixture of the lignum vitae
mm-hmm.
and the islands of the Bahamas,
mm-hmm.
if you would really take a good look. And what I normally would do, I would put a little twist into it, because when you actually collab it together, it forms the actual picture of the blue marlin.
I see.
And then the one up on the top left is the Junknu socks, and it has a little mixture, because you know when you go to Junknu events, it's pretty much wild and colorful, so that's the type of catch I try to have.
Do you have a good supply of them?
Yes, sir.
Oh, okay. And where can you get them in New Providence?
Actually, we are mobile right now, so we don't have any store as yet. So like I said, it's just a small business trying to reach its full potential.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
What is the cost of a socks?
$18 a pair. Okay. Wholesale, we would recommend persons to purchase it like 10 or more socks, and you get the price instead of the 18.
It's quite fashionable, isn't it?
Yes. It is, very yes. much so. And it's a great way, it's a great gift, I think. Really good for
yes.
tourists or for Bahamians.
Yes.
I love the socks. And then I think that it's so smart
yeah.
of him to especially get Junknu groups involved.
Yes.
I've seen that he's doing the group socks.
Okay.
Yeah.
I saw Fast Eddie was really interested in those Saxon socks, and I got to get on the Valley Boys now.
Yeah. Just waiting on approval, because you know, yes, we don't want to distribute the socks and then we don't have any. Because I sort of heard some of the actual groups trademark their logo, so I just want to just make their type of product and then put it on my stuff and then sell it to the persons that I put
well,
up.
Well, you know, you can probably put the Valley Boys on the Junknu socks, you know?
Yeah, like I said, we have the actual designs. Personally, each one has their own design. So like mm-hmm. I said, I'm just waiting for the go ahead to distribute them.
And so you these socks, of course, are for all ages, yes?
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm. From ages to 3 and up.
From 3-year-old to?
Straight. So however you
okay.
want to be.
Yes,
yes.
Very good. You said you're an artist. How
yes,
long
sir.
Have you been doing art?
Basically all my life. And like I said, with me procrastinating on my talent that the Lord gave me, I said, you know, the much as you get older, you start to improvise and get more wiser.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, you know, let's try to critique all these God-given talents that I have been sitting here just catching dust, and we just go with it and just make it happen.
Tell me about how the genesis of it. How do you, this is the final product.
Yes, sir.
But you actually sit down with a piece of paper.
Yeah,
and
a sketchbook.
A sketchbook.
Yes, sir.
Okay. And you design these, you put the colors in.
Yeah.
Yes.
And I have an actual, but I upgrade from my sketchbook now. I purchased myself an actual mini iPad Pro. So therefore I downloaded the actual software
mm-hmm.
and then it actually gives me that colors that I'm basically looking for, instead of just actually wasting funds on crayons and color pencils. So we know we're being more in a modern time, technology and all that stuff, so
okay.
trying to be smart about the situation.
Okay.
It's a much more faster process on my behalf.
All right, and so from your computer, the design goes directly to the
persons who embroidered it, yeah.
To the people who do what?
They embroider the actual socks.
Embroider it?
Yeah.
What is the process there?
Well, the process basically is a machine, a special type machine that is basically abroad.
Mm-hmm.
And like I said, they just provide the actual sketch, because they basically known for customizing not just socks,
t-shirts, hats, mugs,
you name it. So like I said, I just pretty much got in conjunction with them as a partner, and we just basically went from there.
Where you see this going? Where you're taking it?
I'm trying to take it to the international level, mm-hmm. beyond what I've imagined. Mm-hmm. So
you're called a creative, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Innovative.
Innovative, creative behavior.
Yes, sir.
Are you doing things other than socks?
Yeah, but like I recently did a mural for the Rotorack. Mm-hmm. We just grouped together because, like I said, we have persons who volunteer and ask me like to do projects, special projects, like drawing something for their child, whatever. And like I said, yeah, basically anything you ask for, I pretty much could do. Mm-hmm. Pertaining art.
He's a model also.
Yes.
Okay. Yes.
Yes. You model your socks?
Not as yet, but in the making.
Okay.
He brings it to all of the fashion events that you're
yes,
at. He's always wearing his socks.
Yes.
But it's a nice way to promote something and support something that you like. You know,
yes.
It would be very nice of you, anybody,
yeah.
You know, in October, for them to say it's important to wear pink somewhere and support that, you know, that you're behind the breast cancer awareness or cancer awareness. So it's a nice way to just, you know, people wouldn't know it, and it's a subtle way you just move, and they're like, oh,
yeah.
What's that? And it's a good conversation
yes.
piece.
Yes. Catchy.
Yes. So have you, the sister organization and the Cancer Society, and all the rest of them, they should be very pleased that
yes,
yes. you have a product now that they can embrace. Eh?
Yes, sir.
Have you spoken to them about it?
Yes, I did an actual fun run walk with the sister proceeding with the Dorian Hurricane Relief. So that was the event before the pink, the lanes pink at Myers Bolinati. So we've been there already.
Okay, good.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so he's been active, and there's a lot of events taking place
yes.
right now. And so you would always see people wearing the socks, and he's at the event
yes,
supporting
Yes, I'm trying to take as much
everything.
Initiative and chances to get to them, yes.
Good. Mm-hmm. Well, given the amount of resources that Peter Nygard has spent on cancer relief and given assistance to women in particular mm-hmm. In the Bahamas and Canada, you know, and given his expansive fashion empire,
mm-hmm.
he might be able to market this for you as well, right?
I would hope so.
That would be nice. And they're nice and comfortable socks.
Yes.
So it's very cozy to wear a nice,
yes.
comfortable sock. And even if you're going through cancer treatments yourself and stuff, that's a nice idea to make a nice, soft,
yes.
comfortable sock.
Yes.
Isn't it a nurturing thing to just have nice socks on your feet?
Yeah. Absolutely. Now, you have some video for us, eh?
Oh, yes. Well, you know, people have been asking what my dad's been doing lately, and especially with this being the Breast Cancer Awareness Month, that is one of the causes that is very close to our family, and especially to him.
Mm-hmm.
And actually,
his sister was afflicted with breast cancer.
Oh, yes. His sister is a survivor of breast cancer,
right.
And his mother was a survivor of breast cancer,
okay.
And my mom was a survivor of breast cancer, so
wow.
It's very close. And so it's very important for me to get tested annually, which I have been. I've gone through the process of that. It's not a comfortable one, but it's very important.
Mm-hmm.
And I know that in this month, and particularly, then I would get tested now because it's half off. A lot of places where they have $50 deals and stuff like that, so it's a good time to
nice.
Do it and go with a friend. It's nice to have a support team
mm-hmm.
and everything.
Yeah.
But when you talk about socks and stuff, my dad actually made nice soft robes
okay.
for the women to wear that he gives them
mm-hmm.
for their treatments. And we have fashion shows all the time.
Mm-hmm.
That it's for breast cancer survivors.
Mm-hmm.
And so what goes along with that, and you know from
yes.
being a model yourself,
mm-hmm.
that it's really nice sometimes, and especially after you're going through something like that, to just, you might not feel at your best, or you might just be really proud of what
mm-hmm.
you accomplished, because it's a huge deal to
yes.
go through something like that and survive and, you know, fight
yes.
it.
Yeah.
And so he would have a makeup artist and put them in their nice clothes and do everything and invite the family out and friends and a support team, and then they model.
Yeah.
They model in these huge fashion shows, and that's always really the highlight for me to see, actually. It's so touching, and you almost,
yes.
you know, we normally would play I Will Survive, you know, that
yes.
song, and
yes.
and that that segment of the show always brings tears to my eyes. Yes. I think to everybody.
Yes. I've seen huge fashion shows in Canada that Nygard has put on with cancer survivors.
Yes.
And they come out parading women from all age groups, eh?
Yes, that's right. And also that's an important part to talk about too, that it's all ages getting this. Mm-hmm. So it's important to be able to do a self-exam and to know what you're looking for, unusual lumps and everything. And then if you actually find something, then to go get checked, because a lot of people think that maybe cancer hurts, that it's going to hurt, and it doesn't. Mm-hmm. It's a kind of a seed and a knot, and something unusual. So it's important to get to know your body and to do these self-exams.
Yes.
Because you can get it. There's young people in their 20s getting it.
Yes, yes.
Yes.
Well, it's good to see you here today with your new venture.
Yes, sir.
Beautiful socks. In addition to these socks promoting cancer awareness, which are well done, actually.
Yes, sir. Thank you very
congratulations
much.
Congratulations to you on this.
Thank you, sir.
We hope that you have much success in this business.
Yes, sir.
So, let's look at the video.
Okay.
We have a video coming up featuring Nygard for Life, dealing with the war against cancer and cancer awareness for women in particular who have been afflicted with the various breasts cancers that we have the Cancer Society that has been asking people to get tested for the various strains of cancer that women have been battling in the Bahamas. So we look at this video right now.
The mammogram breast screening program, which Mr. Nygard so graciously has done for you, how does it feel?
It feels lovely. And when I go for my mammogram, I always look forward to wearing the gown.
It feels lovely to be in these gowns. When I first started with this, they didn't have these nice gowns.
This feels wonderful. It's as if something I would buy in a store.
To achieve here, the discovery of lab tests for the early detection of breast cancer will have far-reaching consequences. It will mean better diagnosis, better treatment, and better care for women around the world. But the real joy will come in what we'll be able to give back. Because for us, success has a very human face.
You have breast cancer, the worst four words I've ever heard in my life. But you know what? I'm here. After four operations and the both breasts gone, I'm still here.
This year, my mom is expecting her first grandchild. And because of the support of this run, she'll be there for that. Thank you so much.
When it was over, more than $21 million had been raised.
Money that will be used to fund research along with awareness and education programs.
It is the passion flowing right on through your veins. And it's the feeling like you're all so glad you came. And it's the moment you remember you're alive. It is the air you breathe, the element, the fire. It is a flower that you took the time to smell. It is a power that you know you got it well. It is a fear inside that you can overcome. This is an orchestra, the rhythm.
employee and breast cancer survivor, I am very proud to say that Peter Nygard and Nygard International have been supporting the fight against breast cancer for well over a decade.
Decked out in pink apparel helped raise over $750,000 so far in Manitoba.
I'm here, Cancer Care Manitoba. Very proud to be the sponsor of Manitoba Tumor Bank.
Excited, waiting for you.
It's exciting to be here.
The labs that are being built here and some of the important facilities like the Manitoba Tumor Bank that have just continued to grow since your initial investment.
Yeah.
Sure, you see the results. The impact is there. The benefits are there. It's very visible and very measurable.
Last year at this time, I didn't know if I'd be here today. I found out that I had metastasized breast cancer. And when he heard that, he jumped to action. It makes me want to cry when I think of what he's done for me. I don't deserve it. I don't know how I was so fortunate as to have a brother like him. So I'm here as a cancer survivor, thanks to my brother Peter.
Without a name for so long, a beautiful smile to hide the pain. Did you ever know that you're my hero? And everything I would like to be, I can fly.
So we've just watched that video on what Peter Nygard and his organization has been doing for cancer, not only in the Bahamas, but in Canada and other places in the world. And your father has spent millions of dollars on this, hasn't he?
Well, it's been important to him, and he's been a part of it for over a decade now.
Mm-hmm.
And so the total money accumulated now has been over $22 million, actually, which goes into the Manitoba Tumor Fund. And he actually is hands-on in selecting scientists to try to find a cure for cancer.
Mm-hmm.
So he goes there and visits the facility, hired the scientists, and he's like behind and on the scenes of the facility to really try to make a difference.
That is commendable, that in his work around the world in promoting fashion, he has taken the time to really get involved in cancer research and treatment. and to raise the amount of money that he has. That is commendable indeed.
Thank you.
Yes. And you have some things to say to us about how you're going to continue to promote your socks and where people can get them and the cost of them and all of that.
Okay, first and foremost, where you could actually get them at the store is at the Cancer Society, where we have part proceeds, where the company keeps 60% and the Cancer Society keeps 40%. And with that being said, too, we are on Facebook and Instagram. That's Socktacular242 on both Facebook and Instagram. And like I said, we are actually mobile right now, so there isn't any store as yet, but there will be in the making.
Okay.
So.
And so people can, like they say, hit you up on social media.
Yes, sir.
And what is it again?
Socktacular242. That's
Socktacular242.
Yes, sir.
Good, and people can order as many socks as they want.
Right? Even their custom design, their own personal designs, they can actually place an order, and then what we do, we provide them with three proofs, and then we'll just basically go pick their top two, and then we just go forward from there.
This is an expensive business.
Yes, sir.
I mean, expensive to if I want three pairs of socks.
Well, we actually would push the client to get more than three.
Yes.
Like I said, it's really tedious to just get three.
Yes.
Per se. So, yeah.
Good. You want to develop and manufacture as many of these as you possibly can.
As possible can, yeah, sir. Because like I said, we have clients just, you know, purchasing and then it'll come right back. Like, man, I need some more. So like I said, just trying to push them to purchase more than just three.
Very good.
Yes, sir.
Excellent.
I just love that Rashad had this vision and just went through and did it. And everybody needs socks.
Yes.
Everybody uses socks, you know, and I just think it's a wonderful idea. And I appreciate that you went into supporting cancer to go on to that, because every little bit counts
yes.
and helps.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Very good. Well, thank you for being here today.
It's a pleasure.
We appreciate it.
Okay.
Yes,
Bianca?
Thank you.
All right.
Thank you.